Hi, this time I'm going to show you how to make a flower with these gorgeous flower stems from Alola rubber stems. I probably say it wrong, but yeah. Hey, English isn't my native language, so don't bite my head off. So, first you have to stamp these with Memento ink on a white piece of paper. I'm going to airbrush these, so you're going to hear a lot of noise in a few minutes. To airbrush, I use a Taurus. It's a Dutch brand. And you can do it also with a Copic airbrush, but yeah, I like my grown-up airbrush. For coloring, I use Comart colors in violet. Now, stamped all the flowers that I'm going to use on this paper. I use the largest one, the middle and the smallest. There are 5, so I didn't use 2. But you can use them all if you want to, but for this time I'm only going to use these. I do a few drops into the bowl. Now I'm slightly going to airbrush. It doesn't matter if you go outside of the lines because we're gonna cut them out anyway. So this is just so even little kids can color this way. I'm only gonna do 3, the biggest, the middle and the smallest. I'm going to add a touch of red. This is bright red, also from Comart. These are water-based, so they mix perfectly together. It's also translucent, this one. The red turns pink, so not that you think I'm gonna use bright red on it. And I'm gonna just do the middle of the flower. Now I have all this ink in my airbrush, so I'm gonna color some other flowers in pink just to don't waste the ink. Okay, for the next step we're going to cut out the flowers. Try to do it as close on the lines as possible. Okay, so all three of the flowers are cut out. And it's time that we want to raise them a little bit. So with your nail, you're gonna just, I don't know if you can see it, just go over it so the petal will curl up a little bit. You do that just with your thumbnail, just go over it. And you do that with all the petals on all the flowers. It's a little bit of embossing, if I think you can call it. So all three are embossed. Okay, I need a hole in the middle of the flower, so I need to take my needle tool and just make a big hole. Then we're going to take flower. I took this little purple rose. I don't know which brand it is. I got it on a show, so I don't think it's important if it is a brand or not. I just like the color very much. And you're going to layer the first flower, the second flower, and then the third, the largest. And you just push the little stem this way. And you have yourself a nice little flower. I'm going to use this flower on a messy box. It's a silhouette design that I bought today from a Dutch site. I don't know the address out of my head, but I will mention it in the blog post that I'm posting it on. I'm going to add the flower to this box. So, and on my blog you can see the total finished project. I hope you like the flower tutorial. It was really easy, and I hope you don't mind me stuttering English. Bye bye.